It's time for a Southern California real estate market update for halfway through September 2021. And the real estate market is changing and not the way you're hearing in other news sources. We're going to cover Orange County, Los Angeles, Riverside, San Bernardino, Ventura, and San Diego counties and give you your every 2 week market update. And we're going to show you which two counties are acting like brothers from different mothers. And stick around to the end where we're going to dive into the notices of default, which is the first step in the foreclosure process. And now that the foreclosure moratorium is over, there's an interesting change in the data. Hey there, Christian Walsh with Wire Associates. We're real estate agents based in Southern California, helping buyers and sellers and tenants and landlords during these crazy days in California and beyond. And it's time for another real estate market update. But we're gonna give you the news before you hear it on the news. So if you're ready to dive into the Southern California real estate market update, hit that like button. And let's get started. And here we go, time to dive into the data. And as we always say, our email newsletter subscribers, they get all these charts. So make sure you click the link below to subscribe to our free weekly email newsletter. So here we have Orange County, and it's still a darn crazy market out there. So you can see that we have that dreaded twist that we've talked about before, where there are more properties going under contract versus those that are being listed. So this shows you an extreme seller's market, and it continues. Now, let's address kind of the elephant in the room in the national news, and I've already started to hear it, and that is, in a traditional market, things tend to slow down this time of year. And that's absolutely true. And we've shown that in other videos where you have the roller coaster where things slow down as you go into the holidays. Yes, that is absolutely true. But that is not necessarily what we're seeing here. And that's why it's important to look at the year-over-year data. But even more important is to look at old year-over-year data, data from years past. Because when we look at last year, 2020, it was an atypical market. And 2021 has continued to be an atypical market. We need to look before then. We have to see the trends from before. And what we can see is, yes, listings do tend to slow down this time of year, but we are at record low listings in Orange County. You go back to 2017, we're about 200 below that. So we have much less inventory than is typical this time of year. So that's leading to craziness. Now we do have pending sales. So the properties in escrow, those are up. And you can see that as compared to 2017, 2018, 2019, those numbers are up. When you look year over year, 2020, that's an unusual blip. So of course we have a reduction year over year in the number of properties going under contract, but we still are high. Now what you get when you have high number of properties going under contract and record low listings, you get bidding wars. And that's what we're still seeing out there in Orange County. LA, we have record low new listings coming. We have a solid number of properties going under contract. It is a record high. Actually, more properties going under contract in the first 2 weeks of September this year than we had last year in LA. So this is, it's been kind of boring looking at LA's numbers. They've been kind of a three straight lines if you watch my previous videos. But things are changing in LA, and it's actually becoming more of a seller's market, which you're not hearing in the news. That's why we have to look at local data. You're seeing where it's saying the market's cooling. The statistics that are coming directly from the multiple listing for the first 2 weeks of September, which you're not seeing in the news yet, you're seeing here first, is showing a different market. It's showing a market that's actually going to heat up and get even crazier. So just when you think things are going back to normal, unfortunately they're not. So Riverside, we can see, again, record low listings, not just, yeah, this time of year, things slow. We've got record lows. And we are still at high levels of properties going under contract. So again, Riverside, crazy seller's market. San Bernardino, we have an increase in the number of properties going under contract. So we have more properties going under contract in these first 2 weeks of September 2021 than we did last year. So year over year, we're seeing an increase in the number of properties going under contract, while at the same time, we're seeing lower inventory. Ventura has been interesting, and we've been tracking Ventura for a few months now, and we can see that the number of properties going under contract has been low as compared to the other counties that we're tracking in Southern California. We're not at record lows. You can see the 2018, this time of year, we had fewer properties go under contract, but they are low. This is not a crazy seller's market. Ventura has slowed sooner than other counties have. San Diego and Orange County right now are mirroring each other as far as things are in the market. Crazy record low number of properties hitting the market and a solid number of properties going under contract, almost as many, about 50 off from last year, and you can see the twist. So San Diego and Orange County are still a very solid seller's market. So that's a wrap up on single family sales in Southern California. Now taking a look at multifamily, this is one of the only places you can get that data. And again, pulled straight from the multiple listing first 2 weeks of September. And as things tend to slow this time of year for single family, multifamily does not experience the same thing because a lot of folks like to execute a 1031 exchange. So fourth quarter can typically be a very busy time for multifamily sales. So as we're getting into that fourth quarter, but what we have here in Orange County, the market is definitely heated up. The multifamily market screeched to a halt throughout Southern California in the early days of the pandemic in 2020, but it has roared back since. So you can see that we have a lot of properties going under contract, not a lot of new inventory. We don't have the twist, but it's a hot seller's market. Anything coming to the market in Orange County is getting a look and probably an offer. Los Angeles, we have a drop in inventory and an increase in the number of properties going under contract. So there could be some investors who are confident that the eviction moratorium for LA and the state are going to expire at the end of the month, and that is entirely possible. So maybe that's why we're seeing a slight increase in the number of properties going under contract, number of properties being purchased. But you can see we have a drop in the number of buildings hitting the market. Looks like a solid number of buildings going under contract, while at the same time we have a decrease in the number of new listings. So this could lead to a seller's market in Riverside for multifamily. San Bernardino, we have a solid increase in properties going under contract. Looks like a solid normal level of listings hitting. So this is a strong market for sellers in San Bernardino, but not a crazy, crazy seller's market like we're seeing in other spots. Ventura, just not much we can suss from the data because there's so few sales, other than it's kind of a slow moving market. Nothing crazy is happening on the multifamily side. With these numbers like we're seeing on the single family side in Ventura. San Diego, a solid market. We have a reduction in the number of new listings hitting and a definite big increase in the number of properties going under contract. So it looks like San Diego is the most solid multifamily market right now for sellers, a lot of demand, and their local eviction moratorium I know has expired, still have the statewide. So that could be leading to more purchases, more buyers jumping into the market in San Diego for multifamily investment. And halfway through the month means that we can crunch the previous month's numbers for notices of default. And that's what we're here to do. And we're starting out with month over month data. And you're like, I know what you're thinking. You're like, Christian, you always say we have to look year over year. Here's why I'm showing you month over month data. And that is because the foreclosure moratorium ended at the end of July. So August would be the first month that a lot of foreclosures could move forward. So I wanted to see how much of an increase we had. And there is an increase. You can see that for month over month numbers for the notice of default, that first step in the foreclosure process, that we did get an increase. So it's absolutely gone up since the foreclosure moratorium has ended. But now we've got to put it into context. We have to put it into perspective. So how does this compare year over year? Well, of course I'm going to show you that. So look at the massive dip we had last August in 2020. And that's because foreclosures weren't moving forward because of the foreclosure moratoria that were in place. But you can see that the number we have for the respective counties we're tracking for notices of default we've returned to what appears to be relatively normal levels. Don't forget that we will have starts in October and November start to see folks coming out of forbearance. Mortgage forbearance plans will be kicking some folks out. But again, they have lots of equity. At least 90% of those folks will have equity and won't necessarily have to go through foreclosure. Little more perspective, how does this compare to crazy days? We have data back to 2011, which is still crazy, but not the craziest. So this puts it in perspective that we are still well below crazy days of the previous bust. So there are your notices of default. It is definitely time to start tracking these as an investor. It was kind of boring for about the past 6 months or a year to track foreclosures. We were still doing it, but now's the time to start. And we're going to continue to bring content on that. And of course, our email subscribers will get that content. Leave your comments below. I want to know what you're seeing out there in the real estate market. Sellers, are you going to put your property on the market anytime soon? Buyers, have you given up or are you out there actively looking? Let us know in the comments below. Make sure you subscribe to our free weekly email newsletter. We have a link below so you can do that. And you'll get all the charts you saw in this video, plus a whole lot more for tenants and landlords and buyers and sellers. Thanks for tuning in. This has been Christian Walsh, real estate agent with Wire Associates, and we appreciate you.